Hey guys, I'm Ryan.
I'm Adam.
And this is Two Neighbors. Adam, what are we watching today?
All right, Ryan, we always like a little bit of news, you know, type things that go wrong. So today we're doing funniest live TV news interviews gone wrong.
All right, okay, cool.
So, I mean, it's self-explanatory. This kind of stuff, I love. I hope you guys love it too.
Me too.
You never know what you're gonna see, but things are gonna go wrong and we're gonna see them. But before we begin, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel, Two Neighbors. We really do appreciate it. Don't forget to turn on that little bell for notifications because we post content every single day. And don't forget to check out ocanaswag.com, punch in Two Neighbors in the coupon code at checkout, and you'll receive 20% off plus free shipping and pay no tax on some sweet Canadian swag. Now shipping worldwide.
Awesome. So,
all right.
Without further ado,
let's do it, Ryan.
I just kept hearing it. I was ducking and everything. In the house, I got scared. I dropped my hot pocket.
Can I ask you, if you won all the money, what would you do with it?
Bunch of hookers and cocaine.
Oh, okay, that's not good.
I can't walk to school sometimes, and also she thinks I need protective gear when I need to ride a bike.
You probably do. I think I agree with you.
I know how to ride a bike already, even without protective gear.
Did you really snatch an 86-year-old woman's purse?
She wants to hurt me. And the bitch don't even know me. I hope that they beat her some of the women in prison beat her every day for long as she's in there.
People might say that's harsh.
Well, so what she did to me was even worse. I'm supposed to feel sorry for that bitch. I don't.
I told him to kill him all that with a gun. If he didn't get out of my house. When I pulled the gun out on him, I guess he didn't think it was a real gun because he didn't worry about it. He just kept on walking. When he was coming down the stairs and told me he was going to kill me and F you, all that, I shot through a hamper that he was carrying. And it was a full metal jacket bullet. I went straight through the bag of him and was like, and he started crying like a little baby.
Charles, why did you come so early this morning?
Ruthless kid.
The reason why I called so early just to celebrate Martin Luther King's birthday, because I feel it's really good to call, because when Martin Luther King's birthday comes on January, I would say it's important to always call and celebrate Martin Luther King's birthday, because it really is important, and it's good.
My friend came to the door. She said, well, I was on the phone cooking me and my baby some breakfast. And she said, hey, something wrong, it's popping. I said, what? She said, yeah. I said, no.
Look at the jacket, too, the M&M jacket.
She came out her apartment with her baby with no shoes on. I said, oh, girl, it's cold outside. She said, something ain't right. I said, oh, man. She said, oh, man, the building is on fire. I got my kids, and we bounced out. We ain't gonna be in no fire, not today.
Sir, can you please tell us what happened?
I feel like that was rehearsed.
In the room, chilling, kicking like I usually do, drinking, and somebody shot right through my back window, hit me in the chest. And I'm like, shit, get my son out the room. You know, I wasn't even tripping over. It's like a little petty wound, you know? I ain't even tripping, though.
Absolutely. So you did show me on your chest where you were shot. Are we able to see that right now, or?
Yeah, y'all can see that.
Okay, so do we know what happened? Do you know who do you know why they would have done this?
I don't know what's going on, man. I just know niggas probably just want me dead, like, on some other stuff. I don't know.
All right, well, I'm here. And what's your name?
Devon.
All right, well, I'm just talking to Devon, and I can't believe all that just happened.
Well, I just had to kick and water them and stuff, and I walked back to my house there to get my phone so I could play a video game on it. And all of a sudden, I got a big boom. I looked back out my door and the electric pole fell and the lines was falling and the geotracker was sideways into the fence. And as I died, screaming and squalling and running around about like a chicken with head cut off. But I told him we need to get out of that water. But say, I didn't know he was getting eaten up by bees. I thought he was just hot. That girl in that little she had a little red dot, I thought, over here.
Think they learned their lesson?
I'd say by today they are. If I feel like my leg, that's what they're learning.
What is your
that reminds me of Cletus from The Simpsons.
Boomhauer.
Yeah.
Yeah, my dad was an athlete, but now he's pretty fat. he used to eat like 2 liters of ice cream every single night, like a Ben & Murray's salted caramel once. And then he used to get really angry at mom because mom didn't always buy it for him.
Yeah.
But then mom, but when dad got really angry, mom started buying it for him all the time.
Yeah.
And then he had to suck his dad in for photos. It was really funny.
How fat's your dad now?
So genuine.
But dad, he's actually lost 20 kilograms since Christmas.
Yeah.
Because he's seen me eating so healthy because I've been inspired by Sally.
Yeah.
So now he's just eating cucumbers. And so he was like 105 since Christmas, and now he's like 81.
Wow.
Yeah, you know, we had a few odd man rushes there in the first period, which was not good for us, but I mean, everyone had their nerves going and everything like that, and then, which we were glad to just keep him to one and everything like that. And then we went back in the, after the period in the locker room, just talked about what we need to fix and everything like that. Stick to the game plan. Get back
everything
on it,
like
everything
that.
Like that. So off, stick to the game plan, you know.
Sounds like a real true hockey player.
That's a Canadian hockey interview right there.
Your uncle, Stu, played here a while back, I think 20 years ago with Alexandria. Did you get any advice from him coming in here to the tournament?
Yeah, I got a nice long text from him this morning saying don't let the atmosphere, you know, get your nerves shaken up and everything like that. Just play your game, which is what I tried to do out here and everything like that. So, yeah, definitely everything like that.
Moving on to the second Stillwater, your initial thoughts.
I think there was like 10.
It should be a great game. I can't wait to play them. I know they're
I almost wonder if
loss on the season, I believe, and everything like that. And we're ready for
I almost wonder if his buddies put him up to it.
Wonder. Right? It's like the meow.
I am tired.
She is very tired. That's actually, I heard your favorite activity to do at the center here is to take a little nap.
Take a nap many times as I can.
You sound like a very busy lady. Yes. Later today, Flossie's family is going to be coming out here to throw you a big birthday party. Are you excited?
Please don't tell me she dies right there.
Not one bit.
You'd rather be taking a nap, huh?
Are you excited,
Flossie,
for your party?
The people
not
on TV
one bit.
Want to know what the secret is to being able to live so long.
I don't know. I don't fight it. I live it.
She doesn't fight it. She lives it. Any secret food or anything we can all be eating every day to stay as alive as long as you?
I heard
no.
That sounded like a try. I said, what in the world is that? So I was finna get out. He said, no, you ain't. He said, I said, what is that?
This shirt said young and getting
it. I think young and getting it.
He got the windows up and held me down in the seat. And I was hollering, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. It was down and it went up and went right over my van. Thank you, Lord. But that's what happened. It come right over my head.
I can't even imagine the feelings you guys must have been going through. So you actually helped
young and
her
jetting.
Get her down, right?
Is that what it is? Young and jetting?
Have you
no, young and getting it.
Bottle?
Young and getting it. It's not it.
Yeah, at the bottom, IT.
Oh, I see.
At all the damage. I mean, what kind of damage?
Young and getting
it. I didn't see the bottom part.
It was just, I never, it stopped flying in the air. I guess what it done took up here. It was flying out in the air. So it went to the right behind the slaughterhouse. Then it went then it come back down. And it went all around.
When you look down at yourselves and you see that you're okay, what goes through your mind, seeing that you're all right?
That God had an angel over us. And that's what I see.
Clearly.
God is good, because that van, it tipped it a little bit, and that tornado just went over that van, because it came straight to us. And when I said, Jesus, 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 that tornado went up over his van.
What happened?
Oh, well, it's really quite funny. I was in bed sleeping at 2 o'clock this morning. My wife comes in and says, oh, the shop's been, someone ran into the shop, and I said, oh, what? So I jumped out of bed, and all I had was my undies on, and I've walked out the front, and I've seen the car smashed, and I've seen the bloke walking back to the car. Oh, well, I tried stopping him and say, hey, mate, you, like, don't be taken off, like, you've just crashed into the shop. Oh, he goes, oh, mate, I fell asleep behind the wheel. And I'm like, yeah, righto, mate, well, you still don't be fleeing the scene. And he goes, don't be a hero, mate. I wasn't trying to be a bloody hero. I wasn't trying to be a hero. I was just
only in Brizzy.
Chasing down the street, and he was supposed to stop. And he just decided he'd scoot up the road.
All these different
said,
news.
Nah, it's not going on like that, mate.
Multiple
you ran news. Down the street in your jocks.
Yeah, in my undies. Yeah, correct. Chasing down the street in my undies, and then he started getting too far, and I'm like, oh, well, I better catch up to him quicker and come back home and drop my car. and started chasing him up the street in my little purple car. And then he went down a side street, and then the police were coming, and I flashed them and sent them off in the direction of him.
Well, there you go, a possible career in law enforcement for you, Daniel.
Yeah, well, it's a head start, isn't it? All I had was me jocks on. I was chasing up the street.
Like, he's doing the full tour of
all, yeah, like, of all the news channels.
You told me that this is your mate's shop, yes, and you didn't want him to get away.
Well, me mate's mum's had this shop for like 40 odd years, and look at it.
Now, I'm not going to ask you if you've committed any crimes, but you expecting a reward for your amazing neighbourhood watch work here this morning?
Yeah, handshake from me, mate, and I got it this morning.
Oh, wouldn't you?
Oh, that's good. Woo-hoo!
Awesome today.
Good stuff.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
And Daniel has just become the local neighbourhood hero here.
Oh, sign that
thanks
man
a lot,
up.
Guys. Thanks a lot.
Fucking neighbourhood watch. That guy needs his own show.
He doesn't.
Yeah, he does.
That's why they're all interviewing. Yeah, exactly. This guy's good TV.
Yeah. Show back in Sydney. Yeah. Would you like your own show?
If I'm going to be with Koshy, I will.
You know, all good superheroes wear their jocks on the outside, so true, it kind of fits the brief. Yeah. Pardon the pun.
Yeah, oh, but no. I had nothing on bar me jocks.
You missed that bit of the uniform, but that's okay. You're a hero in our eyes. Wow. Well done, Daniel.
Yeah, cheers. Thanks a lot, guys.
Goes to show what you can achieve in your underwear.
Well, we'd been down at Options Tavern at a Stubby's and singlets party and got dropped off by a mate up the road and decided to walk down the servo, get some noodles and went to jump over a sign on the way and slipped over and busted my
come again? Say what?
They're
so Australian, coming from Australians.
So you've got a busted plugger.
I see with the shorts part.
What are you seeing that's happening at the servo?
Pretty concerned about my blowout I had and looked up and saw a white Commodore pull up, two blokes with shirts around their faces and and sort of thought something's a bit sus, so better go and check it out.
But you look like you got reasonable guns. You've been working out in the gym. You look reasonable, buddy.
Mate, I don't go to the gym. I haven't been to the gym in years.
That's good.
James, it's Sylvie here. I gotta ask. I understand you're married. What did your wife make of all this when you got home and told her what had happened?
Oh. I'm not actually married as yet. That was my manager that hacked my Facebook and I was getting married. So. But, yeah, she was more concerned than I guess that she bought me on Thursday night.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, James, have you managed to get yourself a new pair of pluggers?
Yeah.
Mate, I've got the team Mudanger's fishing team. They're going to sort me out with some.
What was
unit
that name of the fishing
team? Helping me out.
The who?
The team Mudanger's. Look them up on Facebook and give them a like.
This is so Australian.
Yeah. You had to ask.
And
I thought that was what he said, and I thought we'll just let it go through to the kids.
You're the reason I came back from holidays. It doesn't get any better. That's our show for the year.
Yeah, you know, there's always good content, like especially news, funny stuff coming from Australia.
There's lots there.
That guy from Brisbane, oh my god, genuine. I think in Australia they call, you know how we call like hillbillies here, like hicks?
Yeah.
You know, people who live in the country or like, you know, are a little bit like, they're in that...
Hicks. Yeah. Yeah.
In that class. In Australia, they call them, what do they call them? I just went blank. Bogans. Bogans.
Bogans?
Yeah, they're bogans.
Bogans.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's this show that I used to watch in Australia called Helzos, and it's kind of like the Trailer Park Boys a little bit, like same type of style of filming. It was a really good show, but like a lot of characters similar to that guy from Brisbane. Yeah, Helzos, that was my jam for like a solid year.
It's funny how when like you say certain things in an accent, like we just said, like what's it called, Bogos?
Bogans.
Bogans, yeah. If we did it Bogans, it doesn't sound... But if you say it with the Australian accent...
Bogan. Yeah. Bogan, mate. Yeah, Bogan.
That makes more sense, but...
So, I don't know, I gotta work on
my,
that.
My favorite one there, definitely the 110-year-old Flossie.
Oh, gosh, and she was so good.
She's like, so they're having a big party for you, you're looking forward to your party, and she's like, not one bit. At least she's honest, right?
At least she's honest. She's like, come on, I'm 110 years old. Like, I have no, none of my friends are around. I don't care about my, you know, great, great grandchild child that's beside me. I'm just waiting to have my day.
Yeah. And I like, she's like, selectively answered questions. Like, she asked one question, just like, no answer. It's like, all right. That was good.
So yeah, great video. Guys, if you have something similar to this or anything at all, please, that you think that's good, please send it our way. Hashtag my request down below in the comment section with the URL link, and we will do our best to get to that video. And don't forget to check out Okana Swag. As always, punch in two neighbors in the coupon code at checkout, and you'll receive 20% off plus free shipping and pay no tax on some sweet Canadian swag. Now shipping worldwide. Ryan, what else should these lovely people do next?
Funny you should ask.
Oh!
Like, share, and subscribe, guys. If you have not done so, please hit that subscribe button. Our quest for 20,000 is, we gotta be real close. So hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell for notifications. We post new content every single day, and we don't want you to miss it.
That's it for our show today, guys. Thanks for joining us, and we will see you next time.
Later, guys.